Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This is Pascal Maynard recording for channel Fireball. And yes, you're reading right, this is Jeskai Saheeli in Modern and not Standard. So this idea came from Anthony Lee, an Australian pro player who played this to a top 32 finish, I believe, at the most recent Modern GP in Brisbane. And I believe Minguchi wrote about it and potentially made a video as well on the channel Fireball with the deck. Sean McLaren streamed with it, and so I decided to make my own version of it and actually try it. It's possible that I should have started with one of their builds, but there were a few things that I either did not understand or extremely disagreed with, so I just changed a few things from all these lists. And I came up with this, and I'm going to be running this through a league. But before we start, I'd like to explain some of my choices. So, the mana base. So, Sean McLaren was playing a bunch of Titans, which is pretty sweet, actually, with Saheeli, because you can play Saheeli, bring this back, make a copy. You have another Sun Titan that brings back something. And then you can make, a lot of shenanigans, attack for a bunch that turn as well, so that's kind of cool. It also brings back Spreading Seas if it goes to the graveyard, and Wall of Omens, Snapcaster, and he was playing a bunch of Ghost Quarters, which I'm not a big fan of if we have Spreading Seas in our deck. So I cut down a little bit on the Ghost Quarter. I only have one. I wanted this Lighthouse because I really like that card, and yeah, I cut the second Sun Titan for an Elspeth, which I think is pretty good right now. It's, of course, it costs 6, but it's against Spant Eldrazi or Death Shadow. If I can land it, it's so good. It's good against Junk, well, Abzan and Green Black and Jun in general. So really wanted to play that card in my main deck. I think there's a lot of somewhat fair decks in the format, so I think it's a good position for Elspeth to be in. And then the rest, I chose Remand as my counterspell. I've seen people playing Logic Knot, Mana Leak, Last and 4 Remand. I think Remand is good in a deck that's trying to somewhat combo, that doesn't drag the game too long. So I wanted to try Remand there. Wall of Omens, I think 4 is a little bit too much. I think 2 or 3 is the sweet spot. It's not good against every deck. Of course it cycles, but you already have a Spreading Seas, so you have a lot of very low impact cards that just cycles. So I don't think you want too many, otherwise you're gonna be flooded with them. You're gonna end up not doing a lot. I had a Spell Snare. So this deck is, I think the main difference that Sean McLaren had over the other list is that he's not playing Bolt or Lightning Elix. So he's basically just splashing red for Saheeli and Wear and Tear on the sideboard. You might have had some other red cards. I don't have them. I changed the sideboard a little bit. And I kind of like just being two color, or effectively two color. It lets you play. It's definitely going to make your mana base a lot smoother. I actually just don't think Lightning Bolt is that good right now. Kind of for the same reason Wall of Winds is not that good against everything. It's weird to say that Bolt is not that good right now. Obviously, it's still good, but it's not at its best. With Infect gone and Death Shadow not having that many targets, it's not playing the Cattle and Steplinks anymore. So they actually don't really have a Lightning Bolt target that's good. So I'm gonna be trying this version. I might end up wanting Bolt in my deck just for efficiency. That sometimes you want to be able to kill stuff on the first turn. Like Noble Irek from Bent Eldrazi and whatnot. But for now, I snuck in another Spell Snare because I thought it could be lacking early plays. So we have a Spell Snare. I added Vindealing Click. I really, really, really like that card in any kind of combo, tempo-y deck. So I could see myself adding another one at some point. 2 Supreme Verdicts and full 8 copies of the combo. That might be too much, honestly. Usually you want to cut a Guardian, maybe, because it's the worst on its own, but with Spreading Seas and Wall of Omens, it's actually not that bad. So I have 4, and
for Saheeli, which is like, you, it's reasonable if you want to copy your Wall of Omens and Snapcasters. So, and that might be one of the reasons I want Bolt, is just to have like a more proactive, like, card that I can flashback with Snapcaster. Because now we actually just don't have that many Snapcasterable cards. I don't know if I can say that. So, the Snapcasters might be a little weak because of that. And for the sideboard, it's kind of like all over the place, honestly. I put most of the cards that I... Because I have no idea how the matchups are going to play out. Like, I have an idea how blue-white-red usually play out in matchups. But this is slightly different. So, I mostly added a bunch of stuff that I wanted to try and that I've liked before in blue-white-red. And I didn't want, like, three dispels or, like, three relics because I want to try a bunch of things as opposed to having too many of a single card. I think Kitchen Finks is pretty sweet with Fiddlyar Guardian and, to some extent, with Saheeli Ray 2. Saheeli Rai. So I want Kitchen Finks, especially since we don't have a lot of red in our deck. Kitchen Finks is a lot easier to cast. And then, yeah, the rest is pretty straightforward. Relic versus Rest in Peace is something that I will find out whether which one is better. I think Rest in Peace might be better because it's like, it doesn't mess around. It's just going to exile the graveyards. However, Relic makes your Snapcaster still alive, so you don't have to board them out or something. So we'll see how that goes. And a Teferi, because it's pretty sweet with the combo, because you can combo on turn 6, so you turn 5, Teferi, and there's not much you can do about it. They basically need two counters to stop you or something. Because they can't play removal, because once it's in play, they can't do anything. So even if they have 6 removal, you play Teferi and you're going to win. So that's pretty sweet. So I'll see you in the Magic Online League. Alright, we're going to be on the play. And we're going to keep this hand. I don't like having two Saheelis, which, you know... Oh, we're actually on the draw. Never mind. I mean, I'm still keeping that hand anyway. But yeah, I don't like having two Saheelis, so might be a reason to cut one. It's a little weak to draw in multiple. Like, the card is a little weak on its own. It's nice to stick uncontested early game. But other than that, it's going to be dead in our hand. It's not going to do much. And here, it's going to take our Wall of Omen, and our hand is not going to do a lot. Play that, because I'm going to get a red tapped Shockland. Yeah. Alright, well, at least Saheeli can, like, fight it. We're gonna discard the extra colonnade. And I believe we have a lot more blue. It's kind of close. I should have played Plains there. Because I would most likely want to discard Island to the Lily, so we have double white. That's kind of awkward. If we had Bolt in our deck or something, might be able to kill the Liliana there, but we don't, and the Snapcaster doesn't really have a good target. We have Path. I guess I could expect, like, cast Path next turn. And then I have to Snapcaster for something else. I could copy Snapcaster at some point to attack the Liliana. Okay, fair enough. I'll keep it. Yes. I think maybe digging for Philidor would have been better. Please take Path. Saheeli. Okay. And Maelstrom Pulse. Okay. And he did not plot to Liliana. He has only one card in hand, so that makes some kind of sense. And I'll definitely play White House. I guess I could have played Plains again, just so that, I could have played Plains so that I can path both Snapcaster path. Now it looks like we're getting Thought Seized. If I let that resolve, yeah, I just let that resolve. Noble. Okay, I'll activate that. Discard that. And then we'll discard path. I guess. So that I can get to like six lands so that I can attack Liliana. I guess I could Lighthouse now in case I find Serum Visions. Yeah. Alright, so you top deck to Rhino, plus to Liliana. And we're in a pretty bad spot now. Gonna shut down this. Set the text for more. Oh, that would have been really good. If we could cast it. Taking six. Down to nine. Elspeth is gone. And Saheeli, which doesn't do much. We'll play it. Anyway. Scry and then tick down to Liliana. I think we can key down on top, hoping that he doesn't attack it. Worst case, we can blink the Spreading Seas. Get a blocker. Okay, that would be really cool if he decides to not kill the Saheeli. No. Alright, now we are dead. Oh, I guess I could draw a path off the Philidor blinking the Spreading Seas. Alright. He wins. Alright, so we're playing against Abzan. Celestial Purge is going to be good. Exiles potential Dark Confident, Grim Flayer, Siege Rhino, Liliana. Excuse me. Kitchen Fix is probably reasonable as well. Relic, Explosives. Vendilion Click is going to be medium, especially if they have Lingering Souls, which they're likely to have if they're Abzan. Roman is usually not at its best in this kind of matchup. And I don't know how much I want to cut. He's playing Noble Arc, by the way, so I think Supreme Verdict is going to be pretty great. I was saying, I don't know how much I want to cut these pieces. I know with Twin it was like almost impossible to combo against a deck with that much disruption. But I think this is a little different here because at least our both of these cards are actually, well, Philidor makes some card advantage, so it's like pretty good. And Saheeli, well, they don't have that many threats, and then if we can deal with them, we still get like a damage and a scry every turn, and as we saw there, it can help killing a Liliana or preventing it from ultimating. So I actually think the combo is like not that bad in this matchup. I think it's bad for the reason that they have like a bunch of removal, but they'll definitely cut some amount. However, they saw the combo, so they might keep like pass and path and stuff. It's interesting. Obviously, we'll have to play a lot more games to finally like figure out whether it's good to keep the combo or to keep more combo pieces or not. I'm not gonna board it all of it for sure. I could do like minus one of each and like plus a relic or something like that. Romana is definitely a little bit better on the play. But it's still a little weak. I think I'm going to try cutting one of each. Do something like that. Relic is fine against like the Goyfs. And if they have Grim Flyer as well too. I'll keep that. I think Roman is still reasonable, especially if he's on the Rhino version. Because they have a 4 mana sorcery, and it's generally pretty against Liliana too. So we need some lands, and I wouldn't mind finding a Saheeli in that kind of spot, so I'm going to Serum Visions right away. Two Spell Snares, Burning Seas, Path. I don't want the Path, and the reason is that it's not that I don't want it, it's just that I want to draw land with that Burning Seas and or Remand. So I'll put the Path on bottom for now, and we have a Supreme Verdict. At least. It's possible I should have put just a Burning Seas in the graveyard as well. Pretty awkward now that he have that he has this Verdant Catacombs. Alright, so I'm deciding whether I want to put that on tap. I'm putting it on tap. Like, do I want to keep I can play Relic and then have Spell Snare up. I'm probably going to do that. If he does nothing, I might just crack the relic for the card. Because I doubt we would like to. I don't think we want to miss land drops. Alright, so it's cracking. Fetch land, got a godless shrine, some sweet expedition lands. Exile that. Alright, so he does have Grim Flayer. I'm gonna Spell Snare it. And probably Spreading Seas the Blooming Marsh. Alright, that's rough. If he runs Liliana, it's gonna be hard. Could have held Remand, but I really don't appreciate missing land drops, so I was trying to get my land right away. And then we can Printing Seize the other one. Now that he's mana short. Pass. And he can see it. Alright, doesn't have another land. Now we're on the draw. Could want to board out more Remands, but I don't think it makes sense to have that much more combo pieces on the draw either. So we'll just keep it as is. Alright, I'll keep that hand. Hopefully called Maid. There's no reason to shock ourselves. Played at Serum Visions. We're not in a rush. We have a somewhat of a nice curve. Scavenging Ooze. So I have the choice between Spreading Seas and Wall of Omens. I think that I like better Spreading Seas. There's always a chance that I screw them up. And I think it's worth taking two. I'll be taking a little bit more because I want to fetch my red source there. But that's fine. I'm going to get Sacred Foundry. Again, I could have shut down the Shambling event instead, but I like attacking the green and black source because that's their main colors. They're generally splashing white, and the white cards are not that good against me anyway. Alright, you didn't even get a green source. It probably has another land in hand, I would guess. Discard a card. I think we can discard Relic. I guess in the late game, if it ends up that Shambling Vent is becoming like relevant, that he can attack with it and everything, then I can even move the Spreading Seas on it. But I think for now, screwing with his green mana is more important than turning off a man land. I'm gonna Celestial Birch that. Play Colonnade. And pass. Thoughtsies. Probably takes like Sun Titan, right? And then I guess if he doesn't have green mana, then there's no point. I was thinking if he has another green mana, you can take Sun Titan, exile two creatures eventually, and then get through my Well of Omens. But I guess that also works with taking Philidor Guardian. If he doesn't have another land, he really messed up big time by getting Godless Shrine instead of like, you know, Temple Guard. I guess he couldn't take Temple. I guess I go. So it's possible that he's only playing one Overground Tomb, in which case he had to get Godless Shrine to be able to cast Liliana, because Temple Garden would not have worked. It's not double black. So our Spring Seas worked out pretty well. All right, we took two. Now we can guess Saheeli, which would die if he draws an untapped white or black source, because he could activate both. I could activate Shambling Vent and attack with Ooze as well. So it's probably going to be Wall of Omens plus Serum Visions or something. I do want to make my land drop, so I'm going to Serum Visions first. Well, I don't want Durmand. I think. Do I want to keep the Philidor? I do have the Saheeli, but I feel like he could easily have removal, so yeah, I don't know. I just want land drops. We have a Sun Titan, so we can play that grindy game. With two path in hand, too. No reason to try and be aggressive with the combo. We did get the land. Wow, he concedes. Okay, well, I guess that was quick. Hopefully we get better games in the next round, so stay tuned.